So very good afternoon to all. So we are starting today unit number 5. So application and case study and field work. So this is what we are going to see in unit number 5. So the syllabus is as follows. So first of all we will see about landslide hazard denotation, which is nothing but I will explain what it is. So we will have a case study about this. Then followed by earthquake vulnerability assessment of buildings and infrastructure case study. So each and everything is a individual case study, okay? So first we will see about landslide. Case study means in India you have to take any one particular location, and in that particular location that particular type of disaster should have occurred, and from that we try to take the details, gather information and try to plot and explain what is the scenario of that particular location in near future as well as in what has happened, okay? That is what we call it as case study. So then we will see about draft, its case study. Then coastal flooding, strong surge assessment. Then flood, corresponding case study for flood. Then forest fire, its case study. Then man-made disaster. From landslide, earthquake till forest fire, it was natural disasters. So there are some man-made disaster also. So that case study also we will study. Any one particular case study we will try to take. Then space-based input for disaster mitigation and management and field work related to disaster management. So this is with respect to unit number 5. So they may ask any one case study. One or two case study they will ask on either choice. So I think you should please listen the lecture, because there is content is not directly available, so it may get confused. So try to listen the class, okay? So today let us start with first one of landslide hazard. So notification is nothing but region of definite character, which is nothing but I am going to take some part in India and I try to tell about its characteristics, okay? So that is what it says. So landslides occurs frequently in area prone to earthquake. So where there is earthquake, there is chance for landslide, because something has to shake, then due to that shake entire landmass has to skid, okay? So normally earthquake will occur both in, we have already seen, it will occur in a land where it is flat, or it may occur in hilly regions, or it may occur under ocean, okay? So under ocean if it is occurring, then that is cause for tsunamis like that. And if it is a plain ground, plain area, that is zero height from sea land, sea level, then it is shaking of buildings and such things. If that same earthquake is occurring in hilly region, then landslides will occur, okay? So the very huge mass of land will get slide, and this may damages your building, roads and other infrastructures. Neotonic is nothing but study of motion and deformation of earth crust, okay? So all these activities we will see. The identification and the classification of hazard prone area according to the degree of actual or potential danger is a necessary step in hazard assessment, okay? So where you will do this hazard, you cannot take Chennai as a place and try to do your assessment, because Chennai, it is not prone to earthquake and all, or it is not prone to landslide. So identification plays a major role. You have to properly identify, and based upon the identified, you have to classify that particular region. So proper identification is required to do assessment. Be a little bit clear. To do assessment, you have to identify a proper. See, you cannot select Chennai and do landslide. So, and then if you are properly, if you have selected some hilly region, okay, then you have to classify. Classify means the entire region will not have same soil structure, same angle of inclination. Let us assume you take Kodaikanal. So from the Kodai road, your hill starts, but all the portion is not having the same slope, same angle of inclination. So that angle of inclination will change, and this change in angle of inclination will have a variation in landslide. Okay, so that is what they say. So proper identification is the first step, then classification has to be done according to the degree of actual, either if you have past record of that particular, see if you take Kodaikanal and see landslides, you might have, this might have occurred in so many years, and that details we call it as actual detail. Then potential is nothing but what we are assuming or what we are going to tell from that. Okay, danger is necessary step in hazard assessment. Okay, now let us start the case study. This case study describes the methods of landslide hazard notation that was tested in Srinagar. So in Srinagar we are taking a particular area. Okay, Srinagar, which is in Himachal Pradesh. So we try to take a particular location and we are going to do the case study. The factors of slope angle, that is the first factor, slope angle, what is the degree of that slope, then lithology, then distance from a major geological discontinuity, then type of land use, you are going to, how you are using that particular land, drainage, if water is flowing, whether the water is going to stagnate or water will drain, or what is the level of drainage. So if this is the mm of water from rainfall, how much is being drained. Okay, then relative relief and existing landslides of the contribute to the slope instability. Okay, for a slope to have an instability, these are the factors. I repeat, for a slope instability is nothing but cause for landslide. Okay, so these are the factors which we are going to take. Okay, so these are the, I repeat, slope angle is nothing but the inclination from the 0 degree, what is the level of angle of inclination of that particular region. Okay, so distance from major geological discontinuity is that we see if there is some discontinuity between your two hill by a small narrow shallow path, then that region will have more effect due to landslide. So that is what they say. Then land use, whether you have used for forest or you are used for agriculture or nothing is been done. Okay, there is some variation. If you do agriculture, something will happen. If you keep it as a forest, landslide will be minimum. If you do agriculture, there is chance for landslide, and if you have not used that land for any purpose, then there is a great chance for landslide to occur. Then drainage, so drainage is draining of water from that particular portion due to any heavy rainfall or any other issues. Relative relief, then existing of landslides, so already if the landslide has occurred, then there is more chance to contribute to slope instability. The study has been classified into 5 zones of instability and the result has been verified in the field. So the place where we taken Srinagar, which is divided into 5 zones, we say we will see what is that 5 zones and all. Okay, then the map of this landslide hazards was served as a base for further studies. So once if I do an assessment and give a report, and that report will be very useful in future in identifying the place where there is more prone or less prone or medium prone. Okay, study involves detailed geological and geological studies in the field as well as air photography. So we take into geology, then geomorphical, and we go for air photography of a particular location. From that photos and from that details, we will do our assessment and finally we will give the result. Okay, now this is the place where we are taking into picture. So this one box is there, so this box is called as study area. So these are the rivers which are flowing. So it is from Delhi, little bit higher when compared to Delhi, this particular region where we are going to do our study. So one small rectangular box which is indicating the study area. So that region we are going to study. So in Gargalwal, that is the place, there is a river which is flowing. This river is also a cause for landslide. Okay, unit ranging in age from this, they called in terms of some civil term, we are just note down, that's all. Okay, we doesn't know what is Precambrian metamorphics, which is nothing. All this they are telling with respect to sedimentation, so not with respect to here. This is a type of, see, there is sediment is taking place over a period of time. A river tried to bring some particular type of sand and try to settle it, and it is going on being settled. So this area, it has started with this type of sediment, and now there is this type of sediment is taking place there. The main rock types are, these are the rocks which are present in that particular region. Okay, and based upon the rock, there is landslide will vary. Okay, so this is the geological information. So you can see this is the river. See, like this marking is there, no? So this is the river which is flowing there. Okay, then they are telling about each types of rocks in our region where we are going to do study. There they might have digged your ground, and they have studied what type of soil or what type of rock is there. You can see here some ash lines they have put here, like brick like structure. So it is dolomite is the type there, and slate. There are so many types of rocks. Okay, this part is little bit oriented towards civil department. Okay, we try to understand that these are the various types of rocks as a material of present inside your earth's crust. Okay, so now the thing what they will conclude is the type of rock will decide about the landslide, because some rocks are more strong and some are very light. So if it is very light, if there is any earthquake is there, obviously that will get easily loosened and there is a chance for landslide. Okay, rock structure, the quarantines underline most of the field area, followed by phyllites and other rocks. This quartz and dolomites are in general odd. They are massive expert in place where thrust, fault or shear zones are present, and the remaining are low strength and have been reduced to powdery material. So if there is some earthquake is occurring, they will get easily powdered. So easily if they get powdered, hello, yeah, I will join. Sorry for the inconvenience. I think meeting was, I came out of the meeting, so we will continue. I think now you are able to see my screen. So we were discussing about the rock structures. So various rock structures are there, and this rock structure, they plays a major role. So this was the region which we have taken for our consideration, and in this region these are the various types of rocks which are there. So we conclude that there are two types of rocks which are little bit stronger, these two rocks, and similarly there are different various types of rocks which gets low strength, they will get powdered and they are more prone to landslides. Okay, then we go for terrain evaluation. Terrain evaluation is the entire region we are going to start evaluation. So hazard zone mapping involves a critical assessment and analysis of past occurrence of landslide in their location, frequency and the magnitude in relation to various geo-environmental factor that influence landslide as a movement. Okay, the factor that affect slope stability are numerous, but we take into consideration like geology, structure, slope, that is degree of inclination from zero level, then hydrology, which is nothing but with respect to water table, and then land use, how we are going to use the land, and relative relief and evidence. Okay, so first of all we start our study with our saying angle less than 15 degree, angle lies between 15 to 25 degree, angle lies between 25 to 35, angle with 35 to 40 degree and greater than 45 degree. See, if there is a slope is greater than 45, it is more prone. Okay, the 25 to 35 slope occupies the largest area. So in our place, okay, the place where you have taken for consideration as a slope of 25 to 35, okay, and followed by 35 to 45 is there. So there is nothing less than 15 degree, then 15 to 25 is not there, maximum of 25 to 35 and a range of 35 to 45 is there. Okay, so with respect to slope, they have again redrawn the graph, same location. See, there is no change in the location of consideration. Our location of consideration is this particular triangle portion only. In this particular triangle portion, first we have seen about what the various types of rocks which is there, then now we deal with respect to slope. So you can see here, if it is 15 degree, it is a straight line. So these are the regions, so it is flat there, then it gradually starts the slope of 25 to 35, and this region is more slope than 35 to 45 degree, and it goes on. So here you can see it is greater than 45 degrees there also. So which means it is like, how you have to assume is, it's like climbing the Kodaikanal from the zero. So from zero you will start climbing. So some region you might have seen, it will be like mere flat. See, if you travel from one place to another place from 0 degree, then slope will not be remain constant. Even if you have went for Tirupati, you might have seen somewhere you will drive like a flat surface, somewhere you will drive with more inclination, that like hairpin bends, they will tell, there suddenly it will rise. Okay, so that is what we are explaining here. We are explaining about the various type, various in each and every place, what is the slope from 0 degree. All this they will measure with the help of theodolite. Theodolite is the equipment which they use. With that theodolite equipment they will try to do. Okay, now you can see here where and all landslide has occurred. So they put a curve here. So this all curve indicates the direction in which landslide has occurred. So if you, in general, if you draw like this, then this is how it gets slides. From this portion it slides down. So these are the various marking has been made where and all landslide has occurred. So I think when by seeing this graph, it is clear that the area what we have taken has more number of landslides. Okay, so that is why we are taking this area as an for our assessment. So you can clearly see here there are more landslide occurred due to your earthquake. Okay, now by putting all the results, okay, they come to a conclusion. See, after taking the value of each and every slope from each and every location, once they get that slope value, they will, with that slope value, they try to finalize. So you can see here with this type of rocks, okay, if place having this type of rock will have less frequency of landslide. So if the landslide earthquake is occurring, assume that earthquake is occurring, if the earthquake is occurring and this is the type of soil which is there, then earthquake may not lead to landslide. Whereas if you have a place with this type of materials as a sand, then there is high risk for landslide. You can see around 0.65, okay, so that is maximum and this is minimum, and these are varying in level. Okay, this and this entire graph is saying about the type of material and the type, depending upon the type, how the landslide is going to occur. Then comes through this, it is slope. When the slope is between 0 to 15 degree, you will have minimum landslide, and if its slope is more than 45 also you will not have landslide because it is vertical in structure. So if it is totally vertical, then it has to totally remove from there, and then only it has to slide. So when there is will be more slide is slide between an angle of 15 degree to 45 degree. In between, if you have the slope, then there is chance for landslide to occur. This is very very high slope, very high angle. So this very high angle region will not get have more frequency towards landslide because it is more or less it is vertical. Whereas these slopes region will have more chance for landslide. And the third one is with respect to land pattern or land usage. Land usage, if you are using for thick forest, then landslide is minimum. If you go for moderate forest, then the landslide is much more there. Okay, then this is, if you are going for vegetation, then it is more, which is mean sometimes you do vegetation, sometimes you are not doing, like that region. So the region which is not continuously gone for agriculture, you do sometime and you leave it without doing anything. So that region also there is high chance for landslide. And this is barren land, which means you are not using for any purpose. So if you are not using for any purpose, there won't be any tree or plant in that portion. If there is no tree or plant, there is no root. If there is no root, there is no person to hold your land. Okay, so in usually in hilly areas, you have to plant trees, you have to make it as a forest, or you have to go for agriculture and you have to use it. If you are not using the land, then that land will have a very high prone towards landslide. Okay, then data analysis, a quantitative approach has been used to provide a better assessment. A numerical weightage called landslide susceptibility value, LSV, was assigned to each of the factor based on the relative importance and the condition of the terrain. So what type of terrain it is, so the terrain you have to calculate what is LSV. LSV is landslide susceptibility value. So based upon your previous information or your information which you have taken from your data, you will calculate this LSV. So that LSV only is going to tell about the susceptibility of that particular region. The field evidence has clearly shown the slope instability is governed by combination of various factors. That is what we say here. So these are the various factors. So if the soil is like this, okay, for example, you take this particular type of soil is there, and if that lies in this region of slope, so this particular type of soil is there with a slope of 15 to 25 degree, with if the land is not being used for any purpose, then there is more chance for landslide. This is how the data is being correlated, and you take a value. Okay, the correlation like this they will take. So they will take first this type of soil, then they will have all types of angle, then they will have all type of usability, then they will take the second type of sand or second type of the material, they will again compare with all the types of angle and compare with all types of land usage, and like that they will do, and that is called data analyzing. So from the data we will try to analyze and we will come to a conclusion. Okay, so landslide susceptibility for various rocks. So these are the various rocks. So you can see here LSI, so which where they indicate this particular type of soil as maximum susceptibility. So there is maximum risk for this type of rock, that is what they conclude, and for this you have a minimum. Okay, slate has a very good capability of withstanding the earthquake. They will just move and they will not slide at all, but the availability of this type of rock is very less. So if it is there, then you will not have a landslide, and maximum landslide is for number 7. Okay, phyllite is the type of material. If it is there, there is more chance for landslide. Okay, next is with respect to angle. If it is 45, 35 to 45, 15 to 25. So this angle, you can see the susceptibility is more when the angle is between 15 to 25. And if the angle is less than 15 degree, it is not at all a slope. It is like a plain area. So there is chance for lesser landslide. Then comes your types of land usage, what you are going to use, and if you are using for thickly vegetated forest area, then LSI is very less, because you have thickly vegetated, so you will have deep roots. So if you have deep roots, then chance for landslide is less. Then comes moderate vegetated area, so it is around 1.81. then you can see this is nothing but you are not using regularly, some occasionally you try to use, so thereby LSI will increase. Okay, and if you are not using the land in hilly area, then there is more chance. You have to somehow try to utilize the land in your hilly region in order to avoid landslide. That is the conclusion. Conclusion is, if you are not using your hilly land for any purpose, then there is a chance for more landslide, which we call it as LSI of that particular portion. Then comes your drainage. With respect to water stagnity, if the water gets stagnate more or less, then obviously you will have effect. Okay, so if drainage is lower, which means water gets stagnated more. If water gets stagnated more, then you will have more LSI, so more chance for landslide. If there is drainage is very high, as soon as rainfall stops, there is no water gets stagnate, then you will have corresponding LSI value. And similarly for medium, why medium is having lesser value than high? Because they get drain up, and drain up will leads to crack, and cracking will leads to landslide. Whereas there should not be much drain, or there should not be much stagnation. Some amount of water should be held by the soil itself. That is why it makes it to have a lesser LSI. All this you have to understand. Now what they have done, in same area, they have identified the region where very high density for landslide. They have drawn with a very black color. Okay, so dark black color, these are the regions where you have more chance for landslide. So once if you have drawn this graph, your assignment is over. Okay, so this is what you are going to give it to public. They will know by seeing the color. So near this Srinagar, this region where you have drawn with a black, where there is more chance for landslide, and there is very low chance for this region, because they might have not been not so much height with respect to that particular position. So the entire graph has been drawn. So this is the conclusion of your first case study. So first case study will end up with you have taken an area. For that area, each and every region you have to mark whether it is severe or it is very low. Once if that marking is complete, then your chapter is over. So you have taken an area. For that area, you have done analysis on landslide, and you have come to a conclusion that in this region, these areas are very high prone, and then moderate, and then low, and then very low. Okay. Conclusion: the methodology adopts for landslide hazard is attempt to map the hilly terrain in relation to instability to assist further development plan. I think conclusion is very clear. They say that you have taken a land, you have done assessment, you have finally told the region where instability is there. So for further development from this map, you should consider and try to develop. You should not develop in place where there is more susceptibility for landslide to occur. Okay, the hazard map prevents a fivefold classification of degree instability, which can be used for terrain evaluation. The fivefold is this: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So with the fivefold diagram you have drawn, so that fivefold clearly classifies the degree of instability which is being caused in terrain evaluation. So this is, with this first case study is over. So I think now you will come to a conclusion how to do a case study and put a report. So this is how you have to do. Okay, next one is, for today's class we will take about drought, which is nothing but lack of water, or there is no water, groundwater itself. So in India we will do this case study. So before going into, we have some introduction. We can feel that the dryness in our throat when we continuously deliver a speech, then we will identify that there is a drain of entire water in your throat, then you will feel the dryness, and that is felt by the land, then we call it as draft. Okay, same way, what is happening in your throat, if it is happening in land, then we will call it as draft. Then cracks appears in the earth, this draft when water is so scarce that existence of life become threatened. So if this is occurring, then it is giving a threat to human being that they cannot live there. Many plant species such as we might have seen like cacti plants where which will have thorns and which will not have leaves. So they can only sustain because if you have leaves, then there will be evaporation. So water stored by the plant will get evaporated. So very small leaves or no leaves at all. Some other survivor dry periods as buried seed. Semi-permanent drought produce arid biomass such as desert and grasslands. Most arid ecosystems having inherently low productivity. So when the land becomes without water, there is no productivity from that particular land. So we classify physical aspect also used to classify drought. There are three. First one is meteorological, then agriculture, and third one hydrological. Causes for drought, we know less rainfall. If the rainfall is not occurring, then obviously you will have drought. Then high air pressure should not be there. If there is very high air pressure, what happens is this air pressure, air falls in instead of rising. With the air pressure down in high pressure zone, no current of water vapor are carried upward. See, if there is, you have very high air pressure, okay. I think you all know from the surface of the earth, when you move up, what happens is air pressure will fall. I think you all know why Ooty is colder than Chennai. The reason is they are very low air pressure in Ooty. So low air pressure, so you don't have more particle get stuck by photon of sunlight. So there is no heating up taking place. But in case of Chennai, you will have more amount of air pressure. And if you go to Rajasthan and see, the air pressure will be more high than compared to Chennai. What happens due to this very high air pressure, the water gets evaporated and this water vapor has to carry it in upward. It has to go up, then only it can form cloud and all. So that will not be possible. So if the air pressure is more, you will not have any upward motion of water vapor. So as a result, no, this water vapor has to go up and get condensed. So there is no condensation. If there is no condensation, no rainfall. Okay. Then monsoon role. See, monsoon is usually there is some flow from one part to another part, and if it is not there, again you will be scarce of water. Then water vapor role. Obviously, water vapor should be traveling from downwards to up. Then only they can form cloud and they can give rain. If there is no water vapor, then there is no rain. Then moisture. In some state, moisture is carried up from the ocean by blowing wind. This moisture is then pushed by other winds until it reaches the location. However, if the wind does not blow at a right time, the right direction with enough force, the moisture fall in other area and suffer from drought. If the moisture is not there, then again there is no rainfall. Then mountain region wind. See, if you have any mountain, one side, if there will be wind and there will be cloud and it will be coming and raining on that particular region itself. On other side, automatically you will lead into drought. So this event you might have seen in Kerala and Tamil Nadu. Kerala receive more rain and we doesn't receive rain because the western ghats are very continuous. Whereas eastern ghats, when you take, there is a break. So there is chance for person to come in, and this is not in case in western ghats. That is why Kerala receives rain, whereas you in Tamil Nadu will receive lesser rainfall. Then rainfall pressure. Generally, rainfall is related to the amount of water vapor in the atmosphere combined with the upward forcing of the air mass containing water vapor. If either of this is reduced, then result. So you should have more amount of water vapor and you should have an upward force also. If anyone is missing, then you don't receive any rainfall. Global warming, we know. Decline of groundwater is nothing but over-utilization. See, already if a region doesn't have rainfall, so if it is having lesser rainfall, in that region you are not supposed to start your factories and all. Because the factories may take more water from the ground and there is no source. If it has been refilled, then no problem. If continuously rain is there, it will get be refilled, and if it is refilled, you can drain. But if there is no refill, and if you are continuously, if you are draining, then your decline of groundwater will take place. Then depletion of forest, we all know, if you deforest it, then the rainfall will come down. Then rainwater harvesting, I think we all done some years back, collecting the rainwater and making them to reach the ground. It should not go waste. So you are not supposed to plaster the entire circumference of your house. You should have some places where there should be soil so that it try to absorb the water. So common cases in India with respect to meteorological inadequate monsoon rainfall. Monsoon rainfall is not sufficient, so it is inadequate. Then high temperature and evaporation and wind speed, all that is not matching with respect to formation of cloud. The unseasoned rain, this is also a major issue. You might have started cultivation, at the time of starting you require water, and you are not supposed to require water at the finishing stage, but what happens is suddenly it starts rains and it starts to spoil everything. So that is with respect to meteorological, all these 3 points. Then with respect to water resource, inadequate water availability, high water loss in storage and distribution. See, you cannot store the water, that is not at all possible, because if you store, it will get evaporated. And again, in distribution, you have to do proper distribution, you should not waste. I think you might have all seen our metro water lorries. They take the water from a location, while transporting they will lose so many of waters, then when they reach, nothing will be there inside the tank. Everything might have been poured in the roads. Okay, so that is also a poor method. And storage also, we cannot store in an open space, whereas if you store, then water vapor will take place. Then over exploitation of surface and groundwater, this is what I have told. If you are not getting a more rainfall in that region, if you go and take your groundwater, then obviously inadequate will be there. Then agriculture crop yield, shift in agriculture practice. You should not move from one type of crop to another type which is not suited for that particular land. If you do that, then obviously that land will get disturbed. So crop damage due to rain and snow, this is what I have explained previously. This monsoon or the rainfall will not be there at the required time. At some other time, if it is raining, then your crops gets damaged. Then comes your population. Population in a particular region should not cross a particular value. So if greater rate, then obviously you require more water, and that cannot be supplied from the groundwater. So these are the causes in India. Then drought in India, in course of 18th, 19th and 20th century, agriculture is heavily depend on climate of India. Then in some parts of India, the failure of monsoon result in water storage, resulting in below average crop yield. You can even quote Tamil Nadu here and Andhra Pradesh. Okay, this is particularly true for major drought prone region, such as, see, if you take drought, Tamil Nadu and all will not come into picture and all, because there are some state with more water scarcity, that is Madhya Pradesh, Haryana, Karnataka, Gujarat and Rajasthan. In the past, drought has been periodically led to major Indian famines, including Bengal in 1770. This is the case study, you have to quote this, okay, in which up to 1/3 of the population is affected or even died. In 1876 and 1877, in which 5 million people died, and in 1899 around 4.5 million people has died due to this drought. So corona itself is nothing when you compare to this. When you compare to your 1876 to 1877, 76-77, 5 million people died in India itself, and here 4.5 million people has died in 1899. So when you see our map, India map, most affected states are Rajasthan and Gujarat. Then to Rajasthan and Gujarat is Madhya Pradesh, Orissa and Andhra Pradesh. This Orissa, we all know, cyclone will come and disturb this region, and when required time, there won't be any water, everything will be drained. So this may leads to a drought in India. So these are the states Most affected states are Rajasthan and Gujarat. Lightly affected states are Madhya Pradesh, Orissa and Andhra Pradesh. So when you see with respect to percentage, Jharkhand is very high, 92%. Then Rajasthan and Gujarat is around 15% when compared to all other. And this is taken for a particular year, okay? At some point of time, Gujarat will be maximum and Rajasthan will be comparatively. But this is just a case study it has taken. So area affected in India, the year which is 1983, okay, 1983, which has touched the very peak of 14 followed by 10 to the e power 5. So this is the time at which India has gone into a tough time. This is people affected in India again in 1987, more people has died, and next to that is in 1979, and next to that is 2013, okay. So with this we will stop today's class. So in unit number 5 we have seen, in today's class we have seen about two case study. One is case study for landslide, another one is case study for drafts, okay. So this, with this we can stop. Now if you are